You don't want to install your metal when it's cold. When it's cold, metal shrinks. When it's hot, metal expands. And what happens is, if you put it on when it's cold and it's nice and tight and you're happy with it, when one side is in the sun all day long and it gets up to 110-115 degrees, that metal is going to expand in all directions, and then what you have is buckling, all right, that didn't show up before. So you're better off putting your metal on when it's hot, and then after that, when it gets cold, it'll shrink, and it'll be even tighter when it shrinks than it was when you put it on. So you always want to wait for a warm day to put your metal on. And if you're in the Midwest, or you're in the or somewhere like that where it's cold all winter, just plan your project so you're not putting your metal on until it's warm enough. 80 degrees is the temperature that the manufacturers pick, and that's even today. They warm the shop up to 80 degrees if it's winter to put the metal on. That's what they do. So those poor guys have to sweat like I'm doing now. It's 81 today. It's going to be even warmer tomorrow when we put the roof on. And it's going to be really important then, because I wish it was going to be 100 tomorrow. Even though I don't like working 100 degrees, I'd rather have the metal expanded as much as possible when I go to put it on, so it'll shrink when it gets cooler. You don't want it expanding when it gets cooler too much, because then you're going to see buckling in your trailer. So if you put your metal on during the winter and then during the summer you see buckles, don't worry, they'll go away when it cools off. But there's really nothing you can do about that. I think that's it for today. We'll do a quick walk around. This is my baby, my helper. Yeah, she doesn't really help me much. She likes to dig though. So yeah, I'm getting the Roberts Unison on, and Bill's going to be here tomorrow. I've been doing what I can by myself today. The entire trailer is, oops, I'm tripping. The entire trailer is insulated now, and I've got the back done. You'll see that I have my taillight wires here. Okay, I've drawn an outline of where the taillights go. All right, and then I also have my license plate wires here for the light, and I'm only going to be installing the front and rear windows for now. The rest of the openings I'm not going to cut out until I get up to my new shop. And there's a reason for that. I would have to take all the windows and stuff out again in order to rebuild them and polish them. So the work that I have to do on the windows, there's no reason to put them in now. I'll just leave it like this. And then once I get up there, then I'll go ahead and put the windows in, cut the window holes out, and put the windows in as needed, as I get them done. So that's where we're at now. Moving right along here, I'm getting short. Military people know what I'm talking about. I've got 28 days left here. I have to have all this metal on and the two windows in it and the door in it before I can move it. So I'm on time. I'm happy with that. And as soon as the metal's on this thing, I'm going to start moving up to the new shop. And life will be good again, I promise you. So this is Mobile Tech, Larry, from CanhamTrailers.com. We'll see you next time. Keep on trailering. And you too. Yes. She wants to go for her walk. It's that time of day.